In 2020, I started my career in a new company located in the United States, where we are using Swift programming language to develop a native iOS application. Currently in the market, there are basically many technologies one can learn to become a mobile application developer. But the question is, in 2020, what is the best technology one should learn and start their career as a mobile application developer? So let's figure it out based on jobs, freelance contracts, and jobs in startup company. Before proceeding, I want to let you know that I will compare jobs, freelance contracts, and jobs in startup companies in three popular websites. For the jobs, I will basically select United States as the country because in my career, I mostly work with remote jobs with clients located in the United States. But for freelance contracts and jobs in startup companies, I will look for the worldwide trends, okay? So my thoughts and facts may vary from country to country and in different websites. So today I will compare these four technologies: React Native for cross-platform mobile application development, Flutter for cross-platform mobile application development, Swift for native iOS application development, and Kotlin for native Android application development. Let's search for some jobs on LinkedIn.com. At first, I want to search React Native and the location is set to United States. So let's type React Native here. So here I'm seeing that there are over 3,400 React Native based jobs in United States. Let's search Flutter. And here I'm seeing that there are 387 Flutter based jobs in the United States. Let's search Swift. And here I'm seeing that there are over 8,400 jobs in the United States based on Swift. And if I search Kotlin, it is showing that there are 3,088 jobs in the United States based on Kotlin. So that means if you want to be a mobile apps developer and want to get jobs in the United States, Swift is at number one position as there are more jobs. But at the second position, I think both Kotlin and React Native can stay as there is minimal difference. But unfortunately, Flutter has fewer jobs in the United States. Now let's search for some freelance contractual project or jobs in Upwork.com. So at first I want to search React Native. And here I am seeing that there are over 800 React Native based contractual works or freelance works in Upwork.com. If I search Flutter, I am seeing that there are 324 jobs available in Upwork.com. If I search Swift, there are 448 jobs or freelance contracts available, and if I search Kotlin, there are only 133 jobs are available. So according to the result of freelance works on Upwork.com, I think in the current market, React Native has more jobs and it sits in number one position. In the second position, both Flutter and Swift can stay as the difference is minimal. But for freelance, unfortunately, Kotlin is the worst position as there are very few jobs or projects. Anyway, let's search angel.co, which is a very popular website for startup companies. Even I work with two companies connected from angel.co. So let's search some jobs in there. So at first, I want to search React Native. So there are 2040 jobs available. If I search Flutter, there are only 251 jobs available. If I search Swift, there are 1499 jobs available. And if I search Kotlin, there are 768 jobs available. So based on the data from angel.co, if I want to get a job, React Native is in number one position. In the second position, we are seeing Swift, and in the third position, we are seeing Kotlin. But Flutter is also worst here as it only shows over 200 jobs only. So maybe there are more jobs or fewer jobs for a particular technology, but if you want to pick a technology just to explore or to learn something new or to scratch with that, then you can pick any technology. There is no problem. If you want to start your career on a particular technology after learning or mastering on that technology, then you have to decide which technology you should select. If you want to ask me what I want to focus in 2020, then here is my answer. As I am currently working in a company where I am mostly working with Swift to create a native iOS application, so I will be more focused in this Swift based technology. If you are really good at something, you can still get job or some freelance works. Though I think in many cases Flutter is not in good position because Flutter is also new. It has only in the market over 2 years. So current trends in 2020, I am not seeing a good number of jobs or freelance contracts in Flutter. If you want to pick a technology like Flutter to just explore more to create your personal application, then I think it's a good choice. If you want to start your career, like you need a job or you need to work some freelance contractual work, then I think maybe React Native is the first choice, because in overall with freelance contracts and jobs and startup company based job, I think React Native sits in very good position. But if you see the jobs, especially in United States, I'm seeing that there are more Swift based iOS application or Mac application development jobs compared to other technology. So you have to decide yourself that what technology you really like and what technology you want to start your career in 2020. So anyway, let me know what technology you are selecting to start your career as a mobile application developer in 2020 and why.